What's up, guys? Eclectic Nerd here again, as always, and welcome back to another episode of No Man's Sky. So, I've come back to the space station here in the hopes of maybe trading with somebody to locate some antimatter, and I have. So, let's just go ahead and check this out. So, I made my warp cell already. Obviously, you do that in the normal fashion. And I'm actually going to, real quick, I have to sell a bunch of crap off. Just because, oh, hang on here. Yeah. Because there are some things that I don't need to take with me. I'm curious to find out if the Viking are still going to be the sort of primary race that I'm going to encounter when I make this jump. Let's see, sell items. Let's see, the sheet and the plate could probably go. There. Let's see, anything else I need to get rid of? Nope, we're good. Alright. This is exciting. We're gonna be setting off further into the cosmos. Ow. Ow. It wasn't that far of a fall. Alright. Pew! Okay. So, we're gonna go ahead and kinda pitch and roll a little bit. So, activate hyperdrive. Open galactic map in space by pressing down. Okay. Path towards galactic core. Oh, so you have different little modes up top there. Okay. So how do I do this now? Right stick, push, select. Ah, there we go. S. Murison 7, class F3P, 2 planets, 2 moons. Unable to warp, hyperdrive has no fuel, what? Hang on, something. Oh, duh. Really? That's it? That's all I get? It's 20%? Okay, let's go for it. We're making the warp. Oh yeah, get the intense techno music going here. Kind of sad I can't like look around and see what's like warping by me. Ooh. Neat. Whoa. Who are you? Alright, I'm going to take a quick kind of sweep around here, looking for anything of interest. The ships are kind of cool. I don't see... It doesn't appear there's any sort of space stations in orbit on this side of the planet, so... It seems the sun is really, really close. I'm assuming this is going to be a very hot planet, so let's go ahead and make planet fall here. Interesting. Another. They appear to all be traveling that way. So let's go see what's going on. Let's show up to the party. I'm assuming it means that there's some kind of spaceport there. appears this is a very scorched planet. Where? Above? Above me? Well, hang on. We're gonna do the planet exploration first. Whoa. No. I want to land on the planet here and check it out. Sensitivity is very odd. Ooh. All right, we have landed. Weather tempered, sentinels minimal, flora not present, fauna barren. Interesting. So let's take a walk around here. Low atmosphere planet. Plenty of resources, likely elevated straight on life support systems. So we found the Sulaw Badlands. So let's see what kind of goodies we can find here. Anything? Geknip? And a shielding plate. Cool. What? Alright. Time to get that discovery money. It's like Christopher Columbus money. That's money you get for just finding things. Let's see, bypass chip. Oh. Like the emerald and plutonium are like grown together. That's odd. Just take it all. Take it all! Okay, let's see if there's anybody home. I'm assuming so, but I'm interested to see what alien race inhabits this planet. Because I haven't seen any of the other races. Hello? Anybody home? Apparently not. Alright. All about that money. Getting them credits. The Keen Observatory. The Seafmonk? Seafmonk? A beacon sent long ago from a distant system awaits my response. Three numbers are visible above an empty input box. I don't know. I think I know what comes next. So typical last digit moves to the end. So 2170. Nailed it! I discover a location within the distant stars. Ooh. What are those giant orange things? What's that? What's this? What's everything? So I want to check out what is going on. Hang on here. I'm gonna test this. Please no crash. Woo! I think I'm just gonna risk it. Yeah, these things. What are these? Let's see, what's this? What's over here? Okay, so it's gonna take me 2 minutes to walk to, so I'm gonna hop in the ship and fly. Anything of interest? Endosite, okay. Start scanning all the plants and formations and everything right away. Just get that knocked out. Okay. Let's see. Anything else of interest? Where's my ship? Oh, right there. That's kind of cool. Giant floating rock. Dang. They weren't kidding when they said increase strain on life support. I'm just gonna... bugger off, sentinels. You don't own the stars. Okay. Gonna fly over to this beacon, this ruin here. That's probably one of my favorite things, are these ruins, just because you get to learn more about the galaxy and the kind of lore behind the different alien races. Even though most of my experience has been with the Viking. What? Did I land on top of this thing? I don't know. Okay, this way. This way. Whoa, this is kind of cool. Knowledge. It's about the knowledge. Another knowledge stone. I've learned the Viking word for blueprint. Alright. Ongasiso landmark? Runes take shape upon the stone. Burning with light, they sing to me of the Viking ancient in the language of my people. The Viking rose in glorious victory, yet noble warriors grew tired and weak. The onslaught against the machines endured for 90 cycles. There was attrition and incalculable death, but victory eluded them still. The endless replication of the sentinels slowed, but could not be vanquished. Interesting. So I'm guessing, from what I've learned, the Viking encountered the sentinels kind of early on in their history, I'm guessing? And that's what kind of drove that. Part of what drove them to become this sort of warlike race. Because there seemed like there was initially like almost a civil war between two factions within the Viking. And then once the Sentinels came, the Viking kind of took up arms against them and sort of united against them. From what I understand. I mean, obviously, there's probably some stuff that I'm missing or just not remembering correctly. Hyperdrive is exhausted. Okay, we're gonna. So I inverted my flight controls just because. The way that they were felt kind of awkward, and now I'm questioning that decision. Actually, yeah, we're gonna fix that and upload my discoveries. There we go. Okay. Whoa, that's different. That is definitely not a... It doesn't appear to be a Viking. Maybe it is. I am intrigued. Reveal to me your secrets. I've learned the Viking word for builds. Keyword for post. Cool. Any more knowledge stones? There's more knowledge to be gained here. I've earned the Viking word for ends. I wonder how many words there are in each individual language. I like the textures on this. This looks really cool. Ashes of the Mwablisi? The monolith rips like paper, opening a window to another world. It is laced with a giant web. Just within my reach, an ancient warrior lies cocooned. It has been there for centuries. Dead, vacant eyes stare through me and into the landscape beyond. It carries a rusted multi-tool, while a bulging web sack on its chest suggests it might carry greater riches on its body. Suddenly, the strange, leathery growth starts to move. Pathetic coward, da-da, interloper, take remuneration. Remuneration? What? I don't... English, please. What? And like... So here's my thing about... I have to look this up. So... Remuneration. Okay. Money paid for work or a service. Money paid for a work or service. Take something remuneration. Pathetic coward. Here's what a mulching web sack. Pathetic something coward something something interloper. Take something remuneration. The multi-tool maybe? I'm guessing. See if this. Okay. Already known. So I guess that was the quote unquote correct answer. I'm having to infer kind of like if I can't entirely read the there's a station up there. If I can't entirely read that, I'm kind of just inferring. I'm kind of filling in the gaps based on what I know of Viking culture, which is kind of cool. But so the thing I was going to point out about the like language learning bit is I think it's far too arbitrary. Like I feel like there should be some, like they could have made a tree system for the language instead of just learn random words. Like, there should be sort of a progression. Oh my god, there's another one over there. Holy crap. Oh my god, there's more stuff over here. Dang. Okay, we're gonna bring it. Okay. Focus on the task at hand here. I'm gonna do these one at a time. But I think the language learning system could have been done a bit better. Because if you're learning a language, you don't learn these big technical terms. You learn kind of common... like the commonly used words, like say how to say hello and you know basic conversation. And I think that could have been that if they had put just a bit more work into it. Research specimen. I'm gonna grab all this stuff first, and then I'm gonna save. So yeah, I think that if they had done the language. In like a tiered or tree where you start off with the basic the basics of how to communicate, and then you would build up to blueprints and technical knowledge. And I think that could have been a very interesting mechanic where you start off with, oh hello, yes I would like to trade with you, and then that grows into, yes I am also a spacefaring life form. What do you know about the universe, kind of thing. And then you could learn more about tech and blueprints and sort of, you know, how to build things and get blueprints and stuff that way, as opposed to this kind of like arbitrary, okay, you gotta, I mean, the piecing together part is okay, is cool, because it's almost a lazy way to implement progression, because or I feel it's like, I feel it's the lazy way to implement progression, because in the beginning, you don't know what they're saying. You just have, and then you slowly acquire bits and pieces, but I think it could have been done a bit better. But then again, that, like, that's just me looking at it from the outside, kind of like, oh, it's, oh, it could have been so much better. I thought I saw something flying around my head. Alright. So these are the ruins of Amisir Moss. I'm guessing he's maybe a place, a person. I live within a new reality. I am inside a vast coliseum and beneath a blood-red sky. The noise is overpowering. Warriors scream and bark at the battle set up before them. Two combatants are squaring up on the crimson sand. One has lost its blade and hides behind a shield. The other stalks towards it with a spear raised. I feel compelled to add my voice to the howl of the mob. Choose warrior. Obey. I'm guessing the spear-wielding one, because he is clearly the stronger of the two. Gladiator plunges the spear straight through its rival's head. It bows towards me. I am thanked with something to help me destroy my enemies. And again, that's kind of where, that's kind of nifty. I don't think it's very good. See, this is the problem. Like, I've gotten comfortable with this and all my tools, and I don't want to have to rebuild this, the homing bolt caster, because it's so, like, this and these two are so ridiculously expensive to build. Okay, I'm just gonna do another quick little scan of the horizon, looking for, oh man, there's another thing over there. Oh, okay, so when you scan something, it adds like a little blip on your HUD. Speaking of HUD, I want them to do a thing. Oh, I've got that vapor thing still I can get rid of. Plutonium. I want to be able to leave the, like, percentage things on there, so I know how I'm... Like, I need to be able to constantly keep track of... what am I doing again? Oh, yeah. I'm just going to charge up my mining beam. Like, I understand that... I'm guessing they kind of want you to use the mechanic of listening to help you keep track of like inventory levels and all that stuff. But I mean, if you look at something like Space Engineers, there's no warning. There's no audible warning for you to keep track of that stuff. You just have to do it on your own. And while I get it that, like, I'm guessing a real spacesuit would have some system in place for you to track that stuff, it goes beyond being useful to the point where it's annoying. Like, I think you should be able to set how often your little suit starts barking at you. Warrior Konka. What you got, dog? Acho Yanbeid, warrior ancestors. The pilot looks displeased at my request to open trade negotiations, but then changes its mind. The equipment I carry has impressed it. What are you carrying? What do you got? What do you got, dog? Shards, plates, gel, canisters, bunch of common stuff. Vortex. What is this? Trade commodity. Dense metal object that long ago materialized within subterranean networks throughout the galaxy. Huh. Ooh. Yep. Bye. Wait. How much of this do you have? Can I just keep buying this from you? I think I can just keep buying this from him. Hang on. Sell. Get nip out of there. Get this emerald out of here. Oh man, I can probably actually make a couple power cells with this, or warp cells with this, and actually, how many of these are my care? Okay, I'm gonna do. Oh shoot, I don't want to sell all of them. Oh well. Okay, bye. I want to buy all of your antimatter, sir. Wow, I can just keep buying this from? How much do you have? You don't have... Huh. So apparently he doesn't, like, have a specified inventory amount of that. He just has all of it. Look at this. Look at all this antimatter. Alright, let's see. Intuition of Kokawasa? How's 16? I bought way more antimatter than I think I should have. I think I went a bit overboard there. You got two extra slots, but I like my multi-tool that I have now. Whoa, this guy looks cool. Flag bearer Enping. What's going on, man? Nong Kong Interloper. Oh man, Jesus. Units unacceptable. The war is silent for a second before looking at me conspiratorially. It looks behind to check for its colleagues before powering down security systems. The warrior pulls open the trade vault at its feet, which seems to be piled high with multi-tool upgrades. It indicates the contents of my inventory as a trade. You know what? I'm gonna leverage my thing here. Threatened warrior buys my silence. Oh, sweet! Bonus! Oh man, I'm gonna trick that out. Hang on, I want to go log this location and save. Because I don't want to risk losing all the things that I have acquired. Okay. Peek. I don't know. I feel like there is some basis of other languages in this game, but I don't speak a whole lot of other languages, so I don't know. Okay, let me see here. What do I need to build warp cells? So I need more thamium, which isn't very abundant on planets. At least ones without the, like, flowering. Oh, look at that. Is that over there? I think I just came from over there. Yeah, because that's next to the monument that I went to. Okay, let's see here. I want to... What's this here? Shield duration and charge capacity improved. Okay, yeah, like that can stay. You can get moved over here. Health, protection, stamina. So I've got 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, so Omegon, Chrysonite, and Plutonium are what I need. Interesting. Actually, I'm gonna go back up into space to gather thamium so I can build more warp cells. So I think I've already got, yeah. Of course, it's always something here. Okay. I kinda want to... Basically, I wanna be able to move kind of freely between the systems that I already have. So I think I'm going to build as many warp cells as I can, and then, because I think the hyperdrive that I have now, once it's full, I should be able to make multiple jumps pretty easily. Okay. Get up in here. And I don't know how this is going to... Because I've heard that there's space pirates. So I don't want to, like, irritate the space pirates. And have them come mess me up. Because I'm not really set up for combat. see here. Nope. Okay, how am I doing on... Go ahead and upload these here. How am I doing on Thamium? I have 349. How many does it take to make one? 100, so I can make 3 warp cells right now. Wait. Yeah. Gather a little more. And I think I'm gonna go hide out in the space station. Let's see here. Okay, so it is above me. Oh, there it is. Ooh. That looks cool. There's a moon there, too. Neat. Alright, use the pulse engine here. Woo, boop! Whoa, whoa, whoa! And there we go. Go ahead and... Man, that sun's bright! That's a bright sun. We are right up in there. Slowly... making our way around, rolling. I like how it's got like a different tiled textured appearance. It's kind of cool. Ooh, slowly rolling. Stop and boop. All right. Probably didn't need to buy that much antimatter, probably. But whatever. Don't really care. This guy looks cool. What's up? Enemy Slayer Ogb. He's got like a brewery going on here. Battle, interloper, suit malfunctions, Viking ancient smile. So suit malfunctions. Let's see here. A red, jagged, and recent bite mark is wrapped around the entirety of the warrior's neck. Claw marks have been dragged through its chest, and its suit's restoration and healing systems are blinking offline. The lifeform barks contentedly at me, satisfied with its narrow victory. It's clear, however, that its injuries are severe. It has trouble breathing. Malfunction, interloper, suit malfunction. Hang on. I'm gonna go get carbon. I'll be right back. It's so nice to be able to kind of back out of the situations like that when you know that you don't have it. Oh, this is cool. Adventure, Envoy, Babblefish, Enterprising, Unknown, Menace, Extreme Survival, Space Plane, Trade. I don't know what this is about. Let's see. Carbon. No, shielding sheets are a hot commodity here, too. Gek relic. Can't just buy carbon here? No, that's not going to help me. I don't think I have enough carbon. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I used most of my carbon. Yeah, I guess I'm just gonna have to give him oxygen. Nora takes some gulps from my respiration systems. Its eyes brighten and it thanks me. Thanks. Avoids something. Shield recharge? Yeah, sure, why not? Let's see, I need to make a bunch of warp cells. Let's see how many of these it takes. to refill. Oh, see, this is one of the things that I find annoying. Like, you should be able to select the item, and it gives you the option to use it to do what it's meant to do. There. Sweet, so now I have a full hyperdrive system. And I've got a bunch of extra antimatter left. Let's see here. Clear that out. Okay. Let's see if there's anybody of interest to trade with, and there is not. Well, I guess I'm gonna go to the other planet and its moon. Scope that out. Okay, so you are here. Float around here for a second to figure out where am I going? Where am I going? I can't see. So I've already discovered that planet. Where? Maybe. Definitely, the other one's definitely further away from the sun, I think. So maybe. We'll try going to the other side of whatever that planet's called, I don't remember. I thought that was it for a second. So are those white lines ships? I'm assuming that's what they are. Okay. So I'm guessing the center of that X in the display area is where you're actually looking at. And then those the lines there, like the those ones above me? Or are they below me? It's nope. Okay, they are. Oh, there we go. Awesome. I think we're gonna go for the moon first, just because it's smaller and it's less things to try and cover and see. Because obviously, there's not gonna be many life forms there compared to the actual planet. So, let's see, 16. 15. I'm gonna wait till I'm probably like, I don't know, maybe 5 seconds. Well, I don't have an accurate gauge as to what the translation is between. We are hang on here. Okay. You don't have very responsive control with the when you're under thrust. Alright, and boop. Oh, that's a big one. It's gonna fly right over. There we go. This place looks cool. It's got this red splotchiness about it. Interesting. Zuvelichne. Whoa! Getting some bad pop in and like almost frame rate drop. Weird. It's got like purple water. Okay, that was just like the sky. Whoa! It's got clouds and everything. What? Oh, I gotta check this out. There's like trees and everything. This is so cool. Find a nice clearing here. Boop. Land. Oh, look at all the trees. Look at all the light. Oh, I gotta scan. I have to scan all the things. Let's see. Weather temperate. Sentinels regular. Flora rich. Fauna scarce. Oh, look at you. Oh, you're so cool. You're like a puma, deer, lizard thing. That's so cool. Oh, I gotta scan all the things. There's so many things to scan. Like, hang on, what are, oh, and you just like, okay, you just bound away like your little kitty. That's so cute. Oh, what do you have? What are you? Okay, you're carbon. Obviously, you're carbon-based life. Oh, and this must be the, what? It's got wings. It's so bizarre. Orthogonal gender. What does that even mean? Okay. Okay, I've already discovered you. Hi. Hi. Are you friendly? Oh my god, you're so cute! Ah! Come back, come back! I want to feed you! Oh, hang on. Okay. Where did you go, friend? Oh, you took off! Oh my god, you're flying! Oh wait, no, those are different. Never mind! Those are different things. Oh, come on. I hate this. I hate having to scan airborne animals. It's such a pain. Nope. Oh, here we go. Come on, seek this fool out. Okay, got him. Where? I know you fell somewhere. Dang it. Bug off. Okay. Well, ow! What the? Jerk. Run away. Ooh, free stuff. Sweet. Let's see. Okay. I gotta do this. Okay. Oh, look at you! You're so majestic! You're like a flying lizard praying mantis bug thing. Boring. Boring plants. Alright, guys. I think that's going to do it for today's episode. I'm going to go wander around some more and try and scan all the things. Why is it... It's like so green here. It's just, am I like taking... Because it's kind of toxic here. Alright, yeah. That's going to do it for today's episode. I'm going to go wander around and scan some more things and try and feed... We can try and feed you. Hi. Hi. No, don't be scared. Oh, you're adorable. So, okay, guys, this is it for real. I'm going to go play around with this little guy, and we're going to go have some fun together. So, until next time, stay nerdy, my friends.